son was 7 years old when I flew to space for the first time. Arriving to space through the windows of my spaceship, I was presented with the overwhelmingly beautiful sight of Earth. I remember wanting to capture the view with not only my eyes and in my brain, but with my heart and my feelings. I was in awe. I was humbled by the horizon-to-horizon view of our home from that very special vantage point. I couldn't wait to share what I'd seen with my son. But I also struggled with how best to describe what I'd seen and felt. I told him to close his eyes and imagine the brightest light bulb ever, and that splattered with all of the colors you know Earth to be, with all of the different shades of blues and greens and whites and pinks and browns, and then to turn the light bulb on. I told him to be ready though, because it's almost too bright to look at. You have to let your eyes adjust. All of the colors are crystal clear and translucent and iridescent, and they're glowing on this sphere that's set against the blackest black background I'd ever seen, and that seems to go on forever. I was in awe, I was humbled, that I was on a spaceship separated from all of the people I know and love, separated from all of the people I don't know too, and yet feeling more connected to everyone and everything below me than I had with my feet planted on its surface. I was in awe, I was humbled by the thought of how perfectly placed and situated this beautiful jewel of a planet is in the universe to take care of us. A little closer, a little further from the sun, not so good for us. Realizing that while our planet is small in the grander scheme of the universe, that small does not equate to insignificance. It is significant. We are significant. I was in awe. I was humbled by the visual and emotional surprise every time I looked out the window. I was captivated by what I was seeing and what I might see next. Traveling around our planet at 17,500 miles an hour, 5 miles per second, we circled the Earth about every 90 minutes, or 16 times a day, with a stunning sunrise or sunset every 45 minutes. Out of the night or the day below, the surprises would emerge. A tiny heart-shaped island in the middle of the Red Sea. The shape of the Amazon River that looked like the profile of an elephant. The trail of atolls in the Pacific Ocean that looked like footprints on the ocean. The patterns of the deserts that looked like chickens had been running all over them. The dotted lights at night on the planet's surface that showed me where the people are and where they're not. I remember thinking that God must have a wonderful sense of humor, that there is purpose in our discovery of these places. I was in awe. I was humbled by the realization that everything and everyone below me is interconnected in all ways. The planet looked alive. I was struck by the sight of lightning storms below. Having grown up in Florida, I always thought the storm was just over my head, and when it was gone, it was gone. From space, I witnessed how that lightning striking over Florida would wrap around the planet to Africa and then out of sight. It looked like neurons firing in a brain. I was in awe, I was humbled, that I was traveling on a spaceship, a mechanical life support system that we built in space to mimic as best we can what Earth does for us naturally. The best example of living off the grid, and the best example of peaceful and successful international cooperation. A wonderful model for how we should be living together peacefully and successfully here on Spaceship Earth. I was in awe, I was humbled, to witness the contrast that can be appreciated from a different perspective. I would watch the planet rotate below me with all the planetary activity that supports life. From my vantage point, the white, billowy, and swirly clouds of a hurricane moving across the ocean appeared soft and quiet and beautiful. It was like I was watching the world below me with the mute button on. I would also be startled with the thought of how different that hurricane would seem to the people experiencing it from below. I was in awe, I was humbled by the new appreciation I developed for home, for our one home. When I first got to space, I would float to the window with excitement every time I knew we were over Florida. I considered Florida my home. I wanted to experience Florida from space. Very quickly though, while I still held Florida close as a special place, and I wanted to see the beautiful blues and turquoises of the water that surrounded its unmistakable peninsula, Florida became a special place on a planet that's my home. I was in awe, I was humbled by the seemingly impossible complexity involved with transporting me safely to space, with being able to live and work in space for even a short period of time, with the science and international relationships, and the fact that all of the work we're doing in space is about improving life here on Earth, and with the ability to travel safely home. I am in awe. I am humbled by the simplicity I discovered from the complexity of spaceflight. For me, out of all that complexity came three simple, yet I would argue powerful lessons. Three simple lessons that I knew before flying to space, that we all know, but likely often don't take into consideration in our daily lives. Not a day goes by now, though, that these three simple lessons aren't actively engaged in my thoughts and my actions. I'm on a mission to share these lessons with as many people as I can, with the hope that everyone can appreciate their simplicity and power in their own lives. They are: we live on a planet, we are all Earthlings, and the only border that matters is that thin blue line of atmosphere that blankets and protects us all. We all need to accept our role as crewmates, with one shared future on our one home, our spaceship Earth.